I just came up with a completely new way to build a welding machine. Nothing like I've tried before. And it all starts with something tiny that most people overlook. A spark plug. Sounds simple, but from this little piece, we'll generate electricity, fire, and the power to weld anything. Curious? Let's dive in and explore. First, we're going to create a short circuit. It's simple. Connect one end of the wire to the tip of the spark plug, and the other end to the spark plug's threaded body. Make sure the connections are secure so nothing comes loose or shorts out. This small step is crucial. It controls the flow of electricity and ensures the spark is strong. The short circuit method we're using didn't just appear out of nowhere. In fact, it's been widely applied in electrical engineering for a long time, especially in machinery and testing devices to quickly check current or produce sparks. The principle is simple. Create a short path for electricity to control energy flow and maximize efficiency. It's a small trick, but very effective. Engineers still use it to test things before moving on to more complex circuits. And that's the first step done. Pretty simple, right? Nothing complicated at all. Just connect it correctly and the electricity is ready to flow. Now we can move on to the more exciting steps ahead. Next, we'll connect one end of the wire to the spark plug's ground terminal. This directs the electricity properly so the spark fires strong and steady. Make sure it's secure, safe but firm enough. Small step, but very important. For extra safety when working with electricity, we'll wrap some tape around the spot where the wire touches the ground terminal. This keeps the connection secure and prevents short circuits. It's a small step, but really important, especially when dealing with higher currents. We'll use this piece of PVC pipe as a handle. Welding generates a lot of heat, so no one in their right mind would grab the spark plug directly. Just a bit of simple creativity with basic materials, and it keeps things both handy and safe. Oh, I forgot to mention an important detail earlier. When wrapping tape around the spark plug's threaded body, wrap it a bit thicker. That way, it will fit securely inside the PVC pipe handle. For the other end of this wire, we'll attach an alligator clip. This part will connect to the positive terminal of the power source. Make sure it's clipped securely so the current flows without any loose contacts or short circuits. Just like in my previous videos, I'm using the core of an AA battery as the soldering tip for this device. Small, simple, but really effective, and it makes use of materials you already have. This method is both cost-effective and convenient for testing our DIY welding machine. You just need to secure the battery core onto the spark plug connector like this, and you're set. Of course, we can't skip this. A wire with two ends attached to two alligator clips. This will connect to the negative terminal of the power source. I rarely use a multi-purpose battery. Normally it's meant for drills or welding machines as the power source for this device. But it turns out its specs are perfect for this experiment, and through the two positive and negative slots, we can supply power to the entire device. Sometimes switching things up keeps the video from getting boring, right? These two are metal washers, and we'll use them as intermediaries to connect the power source to our DIY welding device. Be careful not to mix up the wires. Even a small mistake can make the current flow incorrectly or stop the device from working. The reaction is pretty intense with a 21V power source. Just touch the two terminals of the welding device together and sparks fly instantly. It's impressive. Alright, I'm starting the first experiment now. With these two razor blades, it's not really difficult. But, you know, our DIY welding device isn't a store-bought one, so we can't do experiments that are too big. Small tests work just fine and still show the effect. After this simple test, just soldering these two wires, we'll move on to the more exciting part, fixing an LED by soldering it directly. So don't click away, the best part is coming up. Here I have an LED that doesn't light up. Let's check it out together. As you can clearly see, this LED is obviously no longer working. First, we'll pry open the LED cover to find the faulty chip. As you might know, even a single damaged LED chip can prevent the whole bulb from lighting up. This step is crucial to pinpoint exactly where the repair is needed. I'm holding the bulb close to the screen. Can you see the damaged LED chip? That's the culprit keeping the bulb from lighting up. Before soldering to repair it, we'll clean the surface of the LED chip. This removes dirt or oxidation, ensuring a strong connection and better conductivity when we solder. In this soldering method, I will use solder wire. Technically, the goal is to create a solder joint directly at the faulty LED chip. This action re-establishes a low-resistance electrical connection between the contact points, ensuring stable current flow, thereby restoring the chip's functionality and allowing the LED bulb to illuminate again. This reflects a fundamental principle in electronics repair, restoring conductive pathways to maintain operational performance. After soldering, just wait a moment for the joint to harden and cool down, then you can put the LED cover back on and use it right away. This simple step is important to ensure safety and proper functionality. See, I didn't lie to you. With just a few simple steps, from connecting wires using a spark plug and battery core, to soldering the LED chip, we've turned a seemingly dead LED back into a fully working one. Honestly, when working with DIY devices like this, I sometimes have to tweak things, test and retest until it works perfectly. But that's what makes it fun, and you can try it at home with simple materials too. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe so you won't miss more DIY tips. Who knows? Next, we might upgrade the welding device or try fixing other electronics. Let's keep exploring together.